All right.
I think it's time for the Gorgeous George Show.
I think it's time. Hello there, ladies and gentlemen, and thank you once again for letting me come into your living room and letting me put my hand on the screen and bless you. Oh, Gorgeous George, you blow warm air up my skirt. Yes, Josephine, I do blow warm air up your skirt, and I'll blow as much as you want. Ooh, Gorgeous George, make sure you use ointment. Well, hopefully you're not infested that bad, but if I need to use ointment, I will. I'll be coming around the block, and you'll make us all come. Woo! Kevin, what's up?
Oh, hi! Hi, welcome. Welcome to the Gorgeous George Show. And I am your announcer. My name is Kay Lazar. How you doing? And live. No, we're on tape. From Richmond. It's Richmond on tape.
Richmond, Virginia.
Because what happened is we're on the internet now. How about that? Lucky us. Everything is the internet these days. So
for all intents and purposes, we're on camera.
We're on camera.
We're live on camera.
We might as well be on a 7-Eleven camera.
You're giving away too many of our secrets.
What secrets? People are watching this right now on the internet.
It's live.
On 6 months after we did it.
On pubic asses. On pubic asses. Kevin, listen, man, I don't have to school you. You already know this. Mm-hmm. So why are you revealing the cat out of the bag, revealing our trade secrets?
Trade secrets, okay. Okay, well, I forgot. It's the magic time of year. It's Christmas time. When Thanksgiving is next week. So sure to enjoy your stuffing.
Let me ask you, you know how we do it here.
This is Julia Childs. You take the turkey and you knead it. You squeeze the nipple and you said, bad turkey, bad turkey. And then you take the turkey and you hold it and say, give mama a kiss. And the turkey takes his claw and slaps you across the face. Bad turkey, bad turkey. Julia Childs, I'm losing my voice. Julia Childs is telling you, take her turkey and knead it. And rub the turkey down and even have sex with it, and you might be able to get a full load of chiplets in your mouth.
Have sex with a dead... It's bad enough having sex with a live turkey. A dead turkey?
Ah.
All shaved and everything?
Kevin, you know that we prefer... Over here, we prefer that thing there shaved, by the way. Shave it. We don't want any bushy bush. Yeah. You remember about that? You remember about the smelly pussy, right? And said, oh, the smelly pussy. Okay, right. Ooh, ode to that smelly pussy. Oh, sweet odor that brings them mine. You go meow, meow, and say, come on, I want to play. And none of the other pussies want to play with you. And then you go again and say, meow, 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 why don't any other pussies want to play with me? And then the man with the one eye says, don't worry about them pussies. I'll play with you. I have the one eye. Ooh, yeah, and it will be right on.
In the land of the blind, the one-eyed man is king.
The one-eyed man can see what you're doing and can see every part of your intricate insides.
Oh, man.
So he can see there, so you put his head in there, and it's all so good.
So.
Right in entry. No deposit, no return, stuck there for life.
Have you heard of a new thing going on, the Me Too movement? No. Yeah.
The Me movement?
You haven't heard of it, have you?
What have I done? What have I said? I haven't said a damn thing.
In fact, we have a waiting room in the next with Matt Lauer and Charlie Rose. Uh-huh. You can hang out with them.
Well, you know, listen here. I mean, we have the Me movement.
Yeah.
And then the bowel movement.
The bowel.
Now, the Me movement is good. The Your movement, I don't want to know about.
Yeah.
And the bowel movement, well, we all do that. We all for that.
It's the only movement I care about.
Yeah, because I mean, it moves. And everybody have a right to vote. Yeah. And you have the right to go ahead and go to the bathroom in your own pew. But the only thing is, the thing is you have covered up there in your own ballot. So when you're taking a vote, you're covered up. And when you're taking a crap, you're covered up too in your own pew.
And the and then the voting booth too. You know, they're still having a problem in Florida.
That's what I hear.
They haven't picked.
And now all of a sudden they have just announced that Al Gore is the president. They just announced this the other day that Florida has picked Al Gore and, you know, be their president. Where the hell happened?
Well, all those people voted accidentally for Pat Buchanan in those days, if you remember that. Mm.
Go figure that one out.
Gosh, can you imagine what would have happened if Pat... Oh, I do imagine, because we now have Donald Trump as our president. Mm-hmm. He is exactly President Buchanan.
And what's this going on with Melania? Or, you know, that yes. she's telling Donald how to be president. Melania is just telling Donald, ooh, you need to do that. You need to get rid of her. You need to fire her. And so...
Yes.
What the hell's going on now?
She's a member of the staff. I don't know. I forget the woman's name, but she does not like this woman.
She
works, and he's basically like a typical, like, Donald Trump's typical businessman, typical, like, gangster and stuff. And basically, he actually tells you, you know, there's a baby in that crib. We want you to strangle the baby. And, you know, that's part, that shows your loyalty to Donald Trump. So, Kelly, is that his name? General Kelly, who is the chief of staff, is asked to fire this woman on behalf of Melania at the orders of Melania for Trump.
So
and thus he may just resign because I think he wants to get out of there too.
Let me get this straight. I mean, this man who calls the shots and doesn't take any crap from anybody, and yet his wife tells him, you know, no tang for you, no tang for you. And the Donald's like, well, gee. She's not going to play with my pee-pee. She's not going to fondle my pee-pee. I got to do what she tells me because she's got me by the dick.
Short hairs.
Dick.
Let me tell you. I got to tell you. No, you do. That's that. Well, I mean, women telling their husbands what to do. Ronald Reagan had, Nancy said, we had a psychic. Or astrologer that was telling her.
Well, Nancy and I, we are going to, well, play with the Ouija board. We're going to smith some Elmer's glue, and we're going to see the Ouija board move with our eyes. Well, Nancy, what are you doing back there? Mm-hmm. Nancy, are you part of the corpse down there? Are you alive? You're still moving around? Well, I'm going to just make things happen with my eyes, Will. Just like I did with Iran-Contra. You know what about Iran-Contra, but it was a secret.
That's a very secret. Poorly kept secret. But, you know, Nancy, you know, went to an astrologer. She depended on them after he was shot. And, she was from California. They have all that.
Yeah.
They believe in all that weird stuff there.
Well, you know, I mean, look. And we, you know, I know you, you know, we talk about this, you know, on the phone sometimes. You said, you know, you're a man of science, right? You're a man of science. You're not a man of, you know, mystic illusions or whatever. But, I mean, I've said this before. I'll say it again. There are people that are gifted. We all have some gifts within us. Mm-hmm. If you're in tune with your surroundings, if you're in tune with things, we all are gifted. So I do believe that there are people out there that are gifted. I'm not saying that they're like, you know, the medicine man or the medicine woman or, you know, of course, in Indian cultures, you know, I mean, that's what they did. Indian cultures, they healed people by putting, you know, stuff. And it's called holistic treatment. So basically the holistic treatment is, you know, you put that, you know, in certain spots and you're able to, you know, do things and be able to be healed on a temporary situation. So, you know, so I don't know. There's something to it. There's something to it, I think.
All right. I'm glad you mentioned that. That's a very good point you make. Now, a lot of these, what happens is these holistic treatments and these home remedies and these medicine men in the Native American world, those guys, what happens is they, under the pretense of healing in a mystical, magical way, they create scientific, verifiable changes in your body, and that's where the science comes in that actually does cure you. Now, I'll tell you something else. Acupuncture.
I was going to say.
Acupuncture.
And I've had acupuncture done. And ladies and gentlemen, I'm telling you, it's almost as good as having an orgasm.
Yes.
And if you want to masturbate, you want to masturbate in the corner. I'm telling you, acupuncture is just as good, if not better, in masturbating. You know, Dr. Ruth says, ooh, you got to masturbate. Who masturbate? Well, better than that, have acupuncture.
Yes. Well, the acupuncture is from a culture. Acupuncture is from a culture, China,
yeah,
which isn't really a religious-based culture, unlike the Western cultures are. And thus, they use a philosophy and a way of healing through tea, through acupuncture, through acupressure, all these things. And they actually, it's actually more scientific than people think, but because they have all these Eastern philosophies and everything,
right,
in the play, people tend to think it's all magical and mystical. When actually, the Chinese people are not very, in China, are not all that spiritual people.
Right. Well, it's what it is, because they put needles in there and the blood warms the part. So when they put the needle in there, it's like sewing, yeah, like a sew kit, take the thread and sew. And then you feel it right in the spurn spot, right, yes, in your knee, because it's the blood that is warming up. It's like a cool sensation, almost like when you're biting in a York peppermint patty. Because when you bite into a York peppermint patty, you get the cool sensation of having your balls rubbed. You get the cool sensation of having your balls blown.
Wow. Yes. How come there isn't a line at the candy store just for York peppermint patty?
No, I don't know. It should have a line of the York peppermint patty right in there. That, you know, and it's the coolest sensation. Have that cool sensation going through.
Uh-huh.
So, but
yeah,
anyway.
So that's why I let me tell you something. I'm the type of guy, when I go to the magic show, I want to know how the magician did it. I don't say to myself, oh, what magical powers could Gavin turn an ace into a two.
It's like an old-time recipe.
Yeah.
They put the ingredients inside the concoction, and they stir it up there. It's a recipe they don't tell you. If they give you the recipe, they're going to take you and kill you. Yeah. They're going to kill you if they blurt out the recipe. Mm-hmm. They'll have to kill you. They'll have to kill you if I tell you that. I'm not going to do that. So that's it's the same movie. Deal. Huh?
That's in the movies.
Well, I'm just saying.
Nobody ever says that.
Yes, they do. So it's the same deal. Like, you know, I mean, you're not going to give you, they're going to show you the trick. Because then if you show you the trick, then everybody knows how to do it. But is one thing about knowing about a trick, and it's one thing about being spiritually in tune, mm-hmm, and also being gifted in foreseeing things, having intuition. My grandma read tea leaves. Mm-hmm. Grandma Adele. Adele, and we're not talking about the singer, but we're talking about, you know, and she would read tea leaves. I remember this. She would have clients come over. I was about 4 years old, you know, and she would do that, and she used to do that. That's the Arabic in me. I'm Lebanese. Nobody would have ever known I'm Italian and Lebanese. Nobody would know that, but I am. So I remember that. Remember, you know, that, you know, she could do this. So the Middle Eastern people would be able to find things. Middle Eastern people would find things and be able to do certain things. Now, not to say that you're like a witch doctor. Oh my God, and then the witch doctor. And of course, you know, you think about, they take a chicken and they cut the chicken off and they do all that. Suddenly they inherited it, like in New Orleans, in Louisiana, New Orleans, and, you know, in other places like that. They're spiritually in tune about performing black magic. And of course, you know, it's, you don't mess with that. Black magic.
I have no problem messing with that.
You don't mess with that.
I don't mess with Ouija boards. I'm glad you mentioned
Ouija boards.
I'll tell you something about Ouija boards. They were invented, I'll tell you the year, 1913, a Baltimore company invented, a man actually, the head of the company. They were very popular. People tended to think that they had magical powers. The guy's long dead now, but his grandchildren run the company now, and they make a statement pretty much every other year. This is a toy. This was invented for children to play a game. This says no magical powers at all.
Gavin.
And that's Ouija boards.
Gavin, let me tell you something. You don't F with a Ouija board.
I have no problem effing with
it. You don't F with a Ouija board, because you will find, no, that is something you don't mess with. I'm telling you that right now. I'm not, you know, but that's one thing that...
It's a toy for very simple-minded people. You're right. I wouldn't get in the way of the children's fun. I wouldn't tell kids that the wrestling on TV is fake either, or that guy with the red, with the white beard.
What are you saying to the kids out there? Say that again.
Do kids watch this show?
Of course they do. They sit there with their sucker and their thumb in their mouth and their sucker.
There's a sucker born every minute.
I'm just saying. So, are you saying that there's no such thing as Santa Claus?
I'm not saying that.
You're saying there's no such thing as Santa Claus.
For the trolls who watch the show, I don't want to hurt their simple minds.
God, Kevin. Really?
Yeah.
We don't want to do any crumbs, man.
No.
Don't drop any crumbs. Please don't. Please don't do that. No. All right. So, I mean, you know, the black magic, and then in New Orleans, Louisiana, the black magic, the voodoo dolls, they take the chicken and chop their head off, and they do a ritual and a chant and a dance.
Well,
I don't know.
Let me tell you something. These same people that believe that nonsense are the same people that that the Tea Party types, that get sucked in by from New York, a big city guy, billionaire who has big buildings and sex with better looking women you'll ever have, and all this type of thing, and these people are attracted to it. So of course those are the people, and you know, he's just laughing at them behind their back, you know, and saying, oh, they're believing in this nonsense while I'm like forging a bigger empire than I've ever had could with just simple money.
I don't understand about Trump, though. I mean, and I don't dislike the man. I just think that he should be president of the United States. I mean, I don't dislike Trump. I just think he should be.
A lot of fun.
Yeah, I don't think he should be president. The things that come out of his mouth, I mean, insert foot in mouth. I mean, you know, he's like, his decorum, his manner. I mean, just like that newscaster that was going off, you know, and he's doing, you know.
Acosta.
Acosta. I mean, they said that Acosta accosted that woman. Now, that woman did not want to be in the middle of that. Yeah. That woman who was there, who was the intern, did not want to be in the middle of pushing the man back. A news person, what they do, they have a tendency to ask two, three, four questions. But then, you know, if it's not something he wants to hear, then he's going to say. And I understand, you don't want to disrespect the president. Okay, I mean, look, I didn't vote for him, but he is the president of the United States. He is the president of the United States. We have to deal with it until 2020. And then in 2020, I didn't want to get political. See, that's the thing I want to get. But in 2020, then we can show. We did it in 2018 by the Democrats taking the House. 31 seats now they've taken. So with that being said, that's what you do. And you make sure there's no interference and no collusion and no Vladimir Putin involved. You make sure Vladimir Putin and the Russians are not involved in this. And you do that, and you go down and you do strict contact, strict, you know, count those votes. And do it a different way if you have to. But I've said this before, the popular vote should overpower. I mean, if you want to get technical, we've been running the Electoral College for a long time. It should be now based upon the popular vote. And in order to change that, I don't know how we would be able to change it. Might not never be able to change it, but I believe that's the way it should be. Now, the argument is, well, the big states like California and New York will have more delegation on who's president. Maybe so. But I don't know. I think the Electoral College is broke. The Electoral College is broke. The popular vote, yeah, it's true. California and New York, the bigger states, would have more. But then again, there's more people that reside, more people that are, you know, that's so your vote's still counting, but it's upon your state. It's upon people in your state. And obviously, if you is California and New York ever going to be red? I don't know. But maybe some of the policies of the Republican Party change. Maybe California and New York would be red. Texas is redder than red. Love my Cowboys. All about my Cowboys. But politics in Texas, I question. I love the Cowboys. Now, how about them Cowboys? How about them Cowboys? They're still alive. And that's the bottom line about that. So we got our guy back there looking at that, and he's like, yeah.
Now,
it is.
Now, Texas, I read an article about Texas. It always could go blue because of all the Latinos that have moved there. But right. The way it's been districted.
This is maybe it's gerrymandered. Purple is my shirt.
Very gerrymandered, you know. They have, you know, they have it so that there's a Republican majority there. But I don't think their votes aren't all that different from anywhere else. About 50, probably 55-45. Mm-hmm. Red, and that could always with more different. They could also make a difference in other places that are blue. People can move out.
Well, you know, let me say this. When Ted Cruz wins, then you know there's something not right. I'm sorry.
Ted?
Ted Cruz is a Batman villain. Ted Cruz is the Penguin. When that guy wins an election, there's something wrong in the water somewhere. And don't get me wrong. I love Texas. I love all parts of Texas. I've been through San Antonio. I've been through Austin, Amarillo, of course, Dallas. I go to Dallas pretty much. I used to go there all the time.
Fort Worth.
And I've never been to Houston. But Texas is a, don't mess with Texas. Texas is a big state. But beyond that, like you said, a lot of Latinos, the Latino population has grown by leaps and bounds in Texas.
And they tend to vote Democrat.
So this is where, you know, you still wonder, but then it's still red is red.
Yeah.
So and if it ever will turn blue, you never know.
And Richmond, Virginia now has a blue congressperson.
Yes, Abigail Spanberger, and I love to eat her burger.
Stan Berger,
I call her. Yes, if you got something to say, you know, you question me.
She'll go to the...
I would love to eat her Span burger.
She'll send the CIA operative to remedy that.
I don't know about all that, but Abigail, anytime you want to, you know, well, I can't say that, but anytime you want to meet and greet, we'll do that. Abigail, you got my... I voted for you. I think you'll do a fine job. Okay,
job. She works for us now. So, yeah, I'm sure she'll take your calls. Okay. Your congressperson always does.
Yeah, but
I've known all the congress people.
Yeah, but I mean, if I wanted
four of them,
if I wanted to in a flirt with her, I don't know. If I wanted to flirt with her, probably not.
Oh, by the way, I think I mentioned this last week. Abigail and I went to high school, same high school. We went to the same college. So
yeah,
we
did.
We have the same.
What high school and college did you go to?
Well, we went to J.R. Tucker in town.
Ah.
And I went to University of
Virginia. J.R.
University of Virginia.
Luka. Okay. All right.
And I was in New York last week.
You did? Were. Now, what did you see in New York?
You won't believe. And I haven't. You haven't heard of Batman villains? I saw the head honcho Batman villain. This is quite a story I'm going to tell you now. Okay. I go to see a play, a typical Broadway play, but it was a very good play with Elaine May and Michael Cera and Lucas Hedges and Joan Allen. Was called the Waverly Gallery. Mm-hmm. Okay, so it's a big deal. They had a whole thing on CBS Sunday Morning about it. Okay. So I'm in line for it, or I'm getting in the line. Right. I already have my ticket. And I see a woman, a very famous woman, and I get her, and I smile at her, and she smiles at me. And that woman was Jerry Hall. Jerry Hall used to be married to Mick Jagger. And, of course, when I saw her, I looked to her side, and she has an 85-year-old husband. Her husband is Rupert Murdoch. Rupert Murdoch is the owner of Fox News. He's also the owner of National Enquirer, the New York Post, all these things in Australia, all these 20th Century Fox, Fox Network, all this stuff. He's the richest man.
Well, I knew he was the National Enquirer. I knew the National Enquirer.
So I tap his shoulder, and he turns to me, and I said, "Mr. Murdoch, it's wonderful to meet you." And I shake his hand, and he's kind of hesitant. And then Jerry Hall kind of nods, do it. She's a lot younger than he is. Do it. And he smiles, he goes, "Good to meet you." And I said, I shake his hand. And then I shake her hand, and then I get in the line. So I met... me, you know who I am, the biggest head honcho of the guy Fox ever, News. the biggest villain.
Fox News, it teaches you how not to think and how not to vote. How not to think and not to vote.
Yes.
You know what? Did you get an autograph left from that guy?
No, I didn't want to bother.
Did you get a picture?
No, I didn't get a picture or anything, but I shook his head. Now later on, I thought I saw another actress. You may not remember Brenda Vaccaro. I thought I saw a fat Marlo Thomas, but it turned out to be Brenda Vaccaro. Brenda Vaccaro, of course, in the 80s, you might remember, she was the first celebrity.
Danny Thomas is not going to like you talking about his daughter like that.
No.
Danny Thomas is not going to like
you talking about his daughter. I'm not talking about Marlo. I'm talking about Brenda Vaccaro. She was the first celebrity to do Kotex commercials.
Oh.
And people make jokes about her on Saturday Night Live.
Yum, yum, yum.
But I got to see her. I didn't get her attention to talk to her. But then
you saw Marlo, right?
No, Marlo wasn't there. I saw what I thought was.
Oh, you thought it was Marlo.
Marlo, but it was a fat. I thought it was a fat Marlo.
You should have donated to St. Jude's Children's Foundation.
Then later that weekend, I actually met, and there's a picture of me on the internet. Picture with a Bryan Cranston who's doing a show in New York. Bryan Cranston from Malcolm in the Middle and Breaking Bad, best actor of the
Malcolm in the Middle.
And then I saw, and then I was with Tracy. And Naomi, and we were walking in Hell's Kitchen, and I ran into Joaquin Phoenix, who played Johnny Cash in the movie. And I said, "Hey, how you doing?" And he says, "Hey, good to see you. Good to see you." And we just walked by, and she says, Tracy says, "Is that a friend of yours?"
I said,
"That's Joaquin Phoenix."
You're rubbing with the big wigs.
Yeah,
you're rubbing shoulders with the big wigs of the people in New York.
Yeah, and I said, if he were a friend of mine, we would have stopped the talk. So those were the people I saw.
But I'm saying you still should have given to St. Jude's.
St. Jude's.
So you gave to St. Jude's.
You thought you saw Marlo.
You thought you saw Marlo. You should have given.
Maybe Marlo was there.
I know, so you asked, raise her address. Oh, you're 75? You're 85 years old? Let me see. Oh, my God. Yeah,
the woman that was in the play I saw was 86 years old, and this was her first play since 1960. Famous comedian called Elaine May. I saw her just a few years ago. I met her in New York. She's very nice. But Elaine May directed, she's also a film director, she directed the movie Ishtar, the film, probably the biggest bomb ever. She never made another film.
Right.
So that was my New York. Oh, and let me tell you, what else? I saw the Rockettes.
Right.
I saw the Rockettes at Radio City Music Hall, the Christmas Spectacular Show. I've never seen that before.
What happened when you were in Conemaugh back a few years ago? You made one of those Rockettes fall down. You were on the Conemaugh Show, and you made one of those Rockettes fall down.
That's right. We were at Conan. Where there's a little video, and we can see the video. Oh, what's going on?
I was trying to get her to. Okay, well, we're going to call. I guess we can take it right here. Kristen!
Hello.
I was trying to get you to call the main line, but I guess we can hear. Achilles, are we able to hear this conversation?
I'm able to call the main line.
Okay, that's fine. No, that's fine. You're on my phone, so you should be able to. We're able to hear her?
Yeah.
Okay. So, Kristen, what is going on? We haven't seen you. You haven't been on the show this year. What's up?
Yeah. I moved away, so, I am far away, and children do come first.
Okay.
So.
Well, you should have brought them to the station. I'm sure they would liked it.
Oh, my goodness. I'm not sure the station could handle them. Well,
and the doorbell rings right now. Time. Vince is probably coming in right now, fashionably late like he always is. But he's walking in. I think he's walking in. I'm not sure. The doorbell just rang. So anyway, there's Kevin's here. Say hi to Kevin.
Hey, Kevin.
Hello, Kristen.
Yeah. So
how's everyone doing?
We are doing. And now you've been doing such a bang up job on the internet yourself now, haven't you?
Well, they have this phrase out there that goes, the student will surpass the teacher, and getting attacked and everything has taught me quite a few things that I realized I already knew. I mean, hello, they raised us on computers. We were DOS programs, floppy disks, everything. So, and I just geared everything to my show. I started my own show, Haunting Evidence.
So you're doing your own internet show on YouTube, pretty much.
Yes. All about uncovering the truth.
Okay. We're not going to talk politics because we're going to disagree. We're not going to talk politics, but we will
agree
We will agree to disagree on all of that. But all that being said, it's been, I haven't seen you since my birthday party.
That is true. Yes.
We still haven't seen you.
And Kevin as well, too.
Yeah.
I mean, we've been on since the birthday party. Yeah.
It's just, you're just a voice.
I mean, it's hard to get out. The children
Well, Vince would have gotten you. I mean, Vince just came in fashionably late, like he always does. Always late as can be. I told you, Vince, you get your boss to let you out early, but you don't listen.
Well, if you were my boss, I know things would probably be a little bit different.
Okay, well, that's
obvious.
Come on
back here, pal.
You want to say hi to Kristen? She's on the phone.
Yeah, I can hear from here. Hi, Kristen.
Hey, Vince. I miss you.
All right.
Okay, and I guess he's going to sneak up here and all that, so he's going to talk to you for a little bit.
She can't see him.
I know.
Well, she can't see none of us, but that's okay.
That's right. You can't see me. Look what I'm doing, man.
I can hear y'all.
Yeah, I can hear us. We're live on camera. So anyway, you're doing what you're doing, and that's great.
Yes.
You when we get into this, you're trying. We're trying to do something.
Yes.
Well, go ahead and tell what we've
been talking about. Yeah, I wanted to talk about that. So a few years ago, my sister and my cousin had started a walk against the opioid pandemic that we have going on in our country, and it's pretty much a walk against heroin. And, you know, with everything that's happened in this past year, I think it only right that we start a foundation or include ourselves in something like this to give an honor to Jamie and to everyone else that has fallen prey to this horrible drug, and it's taken their lives. Yeah. And not only taken their lives, but, you know, hurt the lives around them. I mean, you know, they're so wrapped by this evil demon of addiction that they can't see their way out. Mm. And, you know, they are demonized for it, but at the same time, you know, I dated a woman myself for 6 years, and she was addicted to heroin herself, and I had to watch her go through that. It was painful, but I am happy to say she's been off of it for very many years.
Right.
It has been my passion to try to push my friends to sobriety.
Well,
like, I mean, there are other things that are great in life. You know, you should get high on life itself. You don't need stuff like that, and we have to bring an awareness, and especially in Richmond. So many people are falling, and it's horrible. Just even all across the country, it's horrible. And I think as a show, it would be great if we were like, okay, hey, let's do some things with a couple of these foundations. Also, suicide prevention would be a good one, and anti-bullying.
Well, there's a lot of good ones there, Kristen, to use and whatnot. A lot of good.
We should use who we are to also give back a little bit.
Yeah.
Right. There's a lot of good ones to use and whatnot. I'm passionate upon the opiate, and then the heroin and whatnot, heroin and cocaine. I'm very passionate upon that for obvious reasons. So
it's destroying people. It's flipping the chemical balance in their brain to make people do things they wouldn't normally do. And it's changing people. And not for the better at all. Yeah. Not for the better at all.
Right. Well, yeah, there's...
Yeah, so,
Go ahead.
No, I was just going to say, so I think that's a really good thing we could do.
Well, I do believe that. I do believe that it's very good. And I want to do something in regards to that for obvious reasons. Want to do another memorial for her, and I'm working upon all of that.
Oh,
but
absolutely.
Yes, it is serious stuff because...
It most definitely is, and people want to make jokes of it and light of it and stuff, and it's like, it's really not a joke.
We're not giving them... We're not dropping crumbs right now. No, we're not going to give them... You're not going to give them any crumbs right now. No, we're not.
Well, not even in general, even in, like, the media and stuff like that, people... You notice that even in commercials, they try to demonize the addiction, and it's just, we need to stop. We need to talk about it. We need to be more open about it.
Right.
And I think if we do that, it would make somebody that has an issue with it more open to want to talk about it.
Right, of course.
And come forward.
Exactly right. So I do believe that we will do something. You know, it's the holidays again. You know, we have a lot going on. Kristen has invited me for Turkey Day.
Turkey.
So Kristen has invited me for Turkey Day.
Turkey?
Yeah. Well, you should know about turkey, Vince. You're the biggest turkey of them all right here. So, you know. I mean, you know, we just did the Julia Childs, you know, turkey thing. You know, we're talking about how she would takes the turkey and she rubs the turkey down and says, "Woo, turkey, bad turkey. We rub your nipples up and down and make sure it comes out of the wazoo."
Yeah. They, you know, Roseanne Barr, the character Roseanne Barr played, they killed off through an opioid addiction, too.
Yes.
And they actually, I was watching
it. Seriously, that's how they killed Roseanne off the show? See, I haven't watched it since they kicked Roseanne off.
That's how they
got rid of her. I think that's ridiculous.
They killed her off. Well, I didn't know that. They
yeah.
Her.
Yeah, and also, yeah, yeah. But also what's kind of, I'll tell you something very interesting, though, was that they actually alluded to one of the girls on the show. What happened when, how did you feel when your husband died? Because in real life, the young guy that was married to the girl on the show died of a heroin overdose. Mm-hmm.
And that's what I'm saying. We need to bring more light to that and talk about it more.
That's why he's not on the remake of the show, because he's dead. He died pretty soon after Roseanne went off the first time.
Yeah, that's right. That's right.
Well, I don't know if y'all also heard about the ratings with the Roseanne when they brought it back. They said the ratings completely dropped. It's costing them more money to continue to make the show right now.
Yes, it is.
Than they're bringing in.
Yes.
And Roseanne's having the last laugh. And I mean, as she should, it's her show.
Well, that but then. Well, of course, it's funny because John Goodman. John Goodman.
She had a problem with what she said, kicked the whole show off air.
Right, right. John Goodman's character had died at the end of the first season, at the first time they did the show, you know, the character that, you know, he played, he died. So then, you know, when 20 years later, 15 years later, when they brought that show back, John Goodman was right there. John Goodman was right there.
Yeah,
so,
I'm confused about that as well.
Yeah.
So you can bring Roseanne Barr back.
Yeah, it's like pieces of parts of bodies coming back, and then boom, here comes the character back again.
Right, you go.
Actually, and
well,
that's...
Also, you know...
go ahead.
Speaking of people that have been passed away, killed off, I don't know if y'all heard about Stan Lee.
Oh, yes.
Broke my heart, man. Yes. Broke my heart.
But he's 95 years old. It's not like... His cause of death... He was 95 years old! There was no opioid problem with him.
I want to live. I want to see him live to 100.
Biggest question is, think about this. Okay, everyone. Think about every artist, even myself. I know I've got plenty of stuff out there that I've never actually released. So that being said, I wonder what his vault looks like and how much stuff is in there that he has not released. Like, it would totally... be a chance to take a look inside that man's brain. And
this is the guy with Marvel Comics, right? Yeah, yes. Marvel Comics.
Yeah, he's the creator of Marvel Comics. Gotcha. Are you kidding me? Stan Lee? Oh, yeah, man.
Stan Lee.
The world lost an amazing person.
Yeah.
But, you know, Stan Lee was basically a genius. He was 95. He lived a long, happy life.
Yeah.
Well, you lived at 95 years old, you have lived a long life. You live at 95 years old, you live a long, generous life. I mean, that's, you know, hell, the Reverend Billy Graham lived to be, what, 98? 99. Billy Graham lived to be 99. Pat Robertson, I can't believe that guy's still alive. He's as crooked as the sun doesn't shine. But, you know, he's, Pat Robertson is as crooked as the sun doesn't shine.
Carl Reiner?
Yeah, the 700 Club.
Carl Reiner?
I met the man. He's not crooked.
He is crooked. Go ahead.
Carl Reiner.
He's crooked in his ways. He is.
Don't believe him.
He is.
You know who's still alive? Larry Storch is in his late 90s. The guy from Fat Truth.
Vince, I'm going to have to put a dunce hat on you and send you home.
What? What you need is some eyeglasses so you can see far beyond the trees here.
Yeah.
Pat Robertson is a crook. Get over yourself. Pat Robertson's a crook, all right? Get a dunce hat on.
He probably does a lot of good for some people.
Yeah, a lot of good for his own cause.
His own fault.
All right, so anyway, what else were we talking about? So, yes, that was in the news. We were talking about, you know, we're not getting in politics, but, you know, the whole thing with Melania Trump, you know, and how she's telling the Donald what he needs to do, who he needs to fire. That was quite interesting today with Melania Trump.
Seriously? You know. Did I miss that? Man, this is what happens with your mom. I've been folding laundry, cooking.
You actually missed something pertaining to that. Oh, my goodness.
If you had a wife like Melania, I mean, who looks like Melania, you would do anything she says.
I guess she wears the pants, doesn't she, huh? I'll tell you
what. He wears the pants, she wears the panties.
Well, no, she seems like she wears the pants.
I don't think so. Melania has ever worn pants a day in her life.
Yeah. It seems like it like now, figuratively and literally.
Figuratively speaking, maybe, but I mean, yeah, right, when it comes to Trump, everyone knows that Trump's the one that wears pants in that family.
Well, I think Melania wears the pants.
Let me tell you something. Donald Trump and I aren't all that much different. We both put our pants on one leg at a time. Yep. Only he gets to take his off more often.
I don't know, but then you got Mike Pence. I mean, Mike Pence. I don't know what Mike Pence does, you know. But
see, I thought you wasn't going to talk politics in this show here.
Well, we're not. We're not. So we're just events.
I don't want to. I'm not here to talk about
that. You're a rubble raiser. I mean, you're just an instigator, aren't you?
No, you're just making me mad.
You're just an instigator.
Crooked politics.
I'm not talking politics.
Specifically, crooked politics. He hates what I have to say.
Yeah, I'm right.
Oh, by the way.
Dang right. I'm not talking about it.
Before we go, this is our final show in this studio.
Yes, final show in the studio.
Yeah, we're going to be moving
yes,
to
I was sorry
the CBS
here.
Studios in New York.
Okay, I'm not understanding it. I think we should. If it's not broke, you don't fix it. I think that this studio has been here.
Oh,
what they
gosh.
Can do. If it's not broke, you don't fix it. I have.
They broke here?
Well, I mean, yeah, but you have to go to the smaller studio. Come on.
Let me tell you something. The last person to work on this photographic equipment was Thomas Edison. until I was in the studio, I didn't know Fisher Price made a camera.
Well, yes, there is issues with the stuff in here, but all that being said, there's issues with there. But this is going to be a whole lot smaller. Can you believe it? A whole lot smaller than this area
half
is.
Size.
I don't get that. So maybe we'll see.
We get more female guests and we'll get closer. That's
all right. Hold on. One at a time. All right. Kristen, go ahead. What'd you say?
I was about to say, it's not unheard of to move to a library.
Yeah, I don't know.
People do it all the time.
Yeah, well, I mean, you got to be like, oh, shh, shh, shh.
Yeah.
Library, go, shh, shh, shh. You go, we're doing a live show, you go, shh, shh.
They don't let you sleep in the library either. They always poke you.
No, they say, yeah, shh, shh, we're doing a show. You shh, shh, shh. Yeah. And then you put the it involved in it, and then you got shit.
And then, yeah. And then, George, you're not too familiar with libraries. It's a place where there's a lot of books.
Yeah.
you had to sign the back of it. You don't have to do that anymore in the book anymore. You have a card now.
Kevin, you know damn well that you love the scratch and sniff. You know that, you know, if it's got some pubic hair there, you're going to smell it. Scratch and sniff that damn thing. Anyway.
Yes. Libraries are good, ladies and gentlemen. Trust me.
Well, but now those librarians, too. Oh, my God.
Yes.
Some of those librarians you want to go horizontal with and say,
yes.
Hey, Mrs. Bukuda Baker, can I put my student Baker inside of your little, you know, compartment there? Okay. And then, of course, she calls.
I never see any really. No, I have to take issue with this. I've never really seen any really gorgeous women working at the library.
Well, Kevin.
Kevin's been going to the wrong library.
I've been going. I see old ladies that look like that look like the Golden Girls working there.
Well, Kevin, isn't that your speed limit? Is that your style? I thought you liked it.
Well, at the library, I'm not there to look for girls.
Well, you like that.
The new thing out is called reading.
You like that Prudelicious, don't you? For the scamp of 1972?
1972. Actually, I hate to say 1972 doesn't seem all that long to me.
Who's y'all talking about?
Well, I'm just saying, bro.
Now.
Huh?
But now I'm telling my age.
Oh, what's your, okay.
No, like my grandma and my mom always watched Golden Girls, and I loved it. And I mean, come on now.
Golden Girls.
Betty White.
Betty White.
Betty White.
Betty White is still cooking, too.
Yeah.
She's still cooking.
That's what I'm saying. How could you not? Have you ever seen that show Off the Rockers?
Yes.
Off the all the Fockers.
No, I know the show. It's like a can of camera type
show.
Oh,
the Rockers.
With old people. Yeah. Betty White's the host.
What about Meet the Fockers?
I remember
that. Well, that's a movie. I'm sure everyone's seen that.
You've seen that one. Okay. Okay. Yeah, I've seen that.
Of course.
Yeah.
Remember I was talking about Ben Stiller the other day?
That's right. That's right. Yeah.
Oh, and Ben Stiller has a new movie out where he's not in it. It's a serious thing for Showtime. Where, remember those two guys that broke out of jail and no one could find them for a couple of days?
Uh-huh.
And they had sex with the woman guard. Woman worked in the library, in the library. And she facilitated their way out of the prison. Patricia Arquette is
that's what I said, yeah. Patricia Arquette. That's what I told you about her.
You know about
Patricia Arquette.
What
I saw that.
Patricia?
I saw that. They were doing something together. They were talking about what they were doing.
Well, that was,
and I mentioned
that
to Kristen on the phone.
Yeah.
on the phone about her. She was on some other movie or some other TV show that she was on.
Yeah.
Some whodunit. Whatever.
Oh yeah,
she's done
great.
It. Yeah,
she won an Oscar once.
Yeah,
nice.
So that's pretty much.
Oh, by the way, I'm going to be in a new show in a couple of weeks, December 13th, 14th. Look it up on the internet. I'm going to be in A Christmas Carol. I'm going to be playing Scrooge.
Well, there
the
you go.
The last part I played was Atticus Finch.
Yeah.
So my sister told me that this part of Scrooge is more in liking to my personality than the noble and humble Atticus Finch.
Well, Kevin, I think you can pull it off.
Yes, thank you.
I think you can pull it off.
Can't wait.
I act every week there. Yeah, so.
Yeah. All right. Well, look, hey, we are going to talk to you soon, Kristen. We're going to crank some music. I wanted to thank you. And we will talk about your Thanksgiving Day celebration. We will talk more about that.
Yes.
And I appreciate that. And at least you can say that you were a part of the show.
Thank you.
For this year.
Yep.
Yeah.
And some capacity. I definitely tried to be. I've just got a lot going on myself.
Well, that's fine. Well, you keep doing what you're doing, even though we don't agree, and we definitely don't agree on, you know, some things. What you're doing, I think, Lo, just the same, you're showing your freedom of expression, and that's good.
You know, I'm a little rebel. That's what I do.
Okay.
There you go.
That's right.
I'll be with George on Turkey Day.
Have a great night.
All right, Kristen. I appreciate it. Thanks now. Thanks for calling.
Right,
take care. Bye bye.
We'll all be there on Turkey Day with you, Kristen.
Right.
I'll bring the Lay's potato chips.
You got to take the turkey and you got to put it up the wazoo.
All three of us are going to bring
the
turkey.
You take the turkey and you stick it up the wazoo and you make the turkey go gobble, gobble, gobble.
Anyway.
I thought you wasn't taking any phone calls.
I don't take phone calls. Why are you dropping crumbs, Vince? Don't drop crumbs. Vince, don't drop any crumbs. Please don't.
Maybe you sound like Hansel and Gretel with the dropping of crumbs.
Yeah, well, you're dropping something. You're dropping some bird crap when you start talking Republican crap on my show.
Yeah, when you talk about freedom.
You're talking about Republican crap. You're talking bird crap.
See, when
how about them shitskins losing? Well, they lose the yucky ears, but they are going to lose the next two games. And they're going to lose to us on Thanksgiving.
Lose to both Texas teams?
You damn Skippy, I think.
I don't think so.
They're going to lose to us. You're going to lose to us.
No.
Because now we're going to pick apart that defense. We're going to pick apart that defense.
Our defense is ranked fourth. Our defense is one of the best defenses in the NFL.
What are you
smoking?
What kind of grass are you smoking, Vince? You are polluted and deluded.
Have you been smoking AstroTurf?
Yes.
Have you been looking at the stats lately? No, you haven't, because your cowboy eyes have been covering up
long
NFL stuff. See, this is why I have to talk to you.
Well, you know, let me tell you something.
This man ain't going to tell you anything.
I'm going to tell you like it is. Your Redskins suck. They've sucked since 1990. They haven't seen the damn backstorm of a damn playoffs since they played the Yuccaneers in 98. And your owner is a disgrace. At least Jerry Jones wants to win. He meddles a little bit, I'll give you that. But Jerry Jones wants to win. He'll sell his soul to the devil just to win. And Jerry Jones and the Dallas Cowboys are a market. They are the highest franchise of all sports. The value dollar on the Cowboys is worth more than your dead skin. So bite me.
So that's fine.
We've had more wins against your pathetic team throughout. So double bite me.
That's fine, but you won't win this year.
We're going to beat you on Thanksgiving Day game.
No Manchester.
How much you want to bet on Thanksgiving Day game?
How much you want to bet on that?
Do you really want? Do you really want to bet?
Yes.
Me?
Yes.
Do you really want to cry?
Yeah, this year.
Because I've got really some tissue paper for you. Then you can wipe your ass behind.
How much you want to bet? I got $100 on that game.
You got $100, big boy. You're talking a lot.
Shut up, you're talking a lot.
You're talking
$100 on that game. So are you chicken,
Vince? Have you been taking some dick?
No,
I know you.
That's
what it sounds like.
I know you.
It's what it sounds like
because dick is coming out of your mouth.
How many orifices have you been screwed up the bunghole? Obviously, you know. How many orifices have you do you have?
You don't know dick.
Because when you talk in that gibberish, you've been screwed by somebody up the dick by the bunghole.
No, I have to match your dumb ego when it comes to this show.
Well, you know, dunce hat on, yaddy daddy.
No, I don't want to hear no more of your
dunce hat.
Do you have $100 for this bet? Do you have $100 for this
game? Vince, look, what makes you think that your team has a chance? Every dog has his day.
Let me tell you.
Every dog has his day. Other than this. No, just be quiet for. Shh.
You have nothing to say about the Cowboys. The Cowboys suck.
Zip it.
The Cowboys suck.
And you swallow.
And you suck.
And you swallow.
And you suck.
And you swallow.
And you suck.
And you
suck. I'd rather swallow victories than you sucking on Jerry Jones' dick.
You know something.
How about that?
Come talk to me when you can win a damn playoff game.
Oh, you haven't done that yet.
Talk to me when you can do something productive.
What's my son doing?
Because the dunce hat, we've won playoff games under Tony Romo, and
who?
I don't have the Tony Romo.
Who's Tony Romo. That guy who's in the
better quarterback right than your team has ever had and ever seen.
Oh, let me ask you.
Let's see, Gus Frat.
No, let me ask you.
Let me go back here. Hold on. Brad Johnston. These dead skinned fans. Who else?
Sammy Jurgensen.
Well, he looks like a penis anyway. He has shit like a penis anyway. Hey,
just like his head.
And hold on. What other curmudgeon or misfit has been quarterbacking your team throughout?
Doug Williams.
Alex Smith.
Oh yeah, I remember that guy. Yeah.
And when was that? When was that pre-tell? 1987?
At least we won.
Under the Reagan administration? Are you kidding me?
At least we won.
When? 1987.
Yeah, I'll take that victory.
Yeah, how about the three Super Bowls of the 90s? How about America's team mantra? The mantra and the moniker of America's team.
You're talking about going back to
I'm talking about
the 90s here.
Well, at least we're talking under Clinton because Clinton was newer than Reagan. Reagan is the 80s, Clinton was the 90s, and we're talking 90s. I think the 90s were pretty much a little bit closer in time than the 80s were. In the 80s, what were you, in grammar school? Okay. So, how old are you now?
Same as you.
No, well, you're probably...
The Giants won twice when Obama was president.
So, what I'm telling you, sir, is get a number two pencil... And rethink it. I'm going to give you a week to think about it.
I don't need a week to think about it. You're basically. Let me.
You want. You, wait. So
he's
you
throwing out this garbage here about his Cowboys. I'm here to put down $100 on the game. I just want to hear yes or no. You want $100 on this game or not?
I've taken your money before, man.
You have. And I won't.
I've taken your money so many times.
He has.
It's not
before.
Even freaking funny.
But this time, I know I'm going to win. I'm going to win this game. $100. What you got?
I got $100. I'll give you some toilet paper and you can cry your eyes out or wipe.
I got something for you. This is a gift I got you from New York. It's a napkin from the Hard Rock Cafe. It's a very fancy restaurant in New York, the Hard Rock Cafe. So I thought, I have one for you too. And you could put it at your plate and you could pretend at home that you're eating at the Hard Rock Cafe. When you eat your pork and beans and your...
boisterous, man. What kind of saltpeter? You need some saltpeter or something, man. God,
man.
You're going to have to just deal with it and take some damn... Take your medicine, man.
What medicine?
Your team is a suck.
Take your medicine.
I'm taking your money. I'm taking your money like taking Katie away from a baby. Come on, take your Thor away from a baby.
Take your crock back.
He's chicken. He's chicken. reminds me of something. And I was like, I was at home, okay? I was at home, and I had a, you know, one of them Halloween costumes, okay? And, you know, I'm sorry, Halloween passed, and it was like, oh, well, my fault.
You know what? I'm supposed to do karaoke right now. You're taking up my damn time.
Real quick.
Got 3 minutes left here.
Okay,
yeah,
so basically, it's like it's a horsey costume, okay? And there's two parters.
I heard this crap before. And you were the tail end, and I was the front end. There you go.
I've heard this
diarrhea before. Your team sucks a lot of cock.
Whoa.
Okay, I've said
$20.
I'll do 100, but I'm going to give you a week to think about it.
I don't need a week.
I'm giving you a week to think about it.
Ladies and gentlemen, on television.
Yeah, I'm going to be a week to think
about it. While he thinks about singing a karaoke song, I'm going to get my $100.
Well, you know what? What you need to do is just take a pill and chill. I am, baby, what's causing all this. I am the Mac Daddy. I am the Aretha. I am the Omega. I am, baby, the man. We've got how many minutes now? 1 minute? I see. I know.
Come back up here. I'll forgive you.
Okay.
Come
so on. I am.
$100.
One Mona Lisa, one Leaning Tower of Pisa, and there's only one Gorgeous George. Now, where did you get those shoes from?
I know. I got these in New York.
Okay.
And now I don't have to. Now it's a tax write-off. I'm going to show them on television.
Okay.
So.
All right. God is worth it, baby. So is Gorgeous George. Believe it or not.
See you next year.
See you. Bye-bye. Never again from the studio.
Yeah, okay. Well, no. Never say never.
Oh, that's right.
Never say never.
Oh, wait a minute.
Never can say goodbye. No. Hey. Never can say goodbye. No. Kevin, wait. Okay. Cause a candy man can, cause he fits it up the world and he pisses in his pants. God, a candy man can, cause he pisses in his pants and makes the girls go, All right. Merry Christmas. Happy New Year. We'll see you soon.
Merry Clintmas.
And Merry Clintmas.